Sure. Okay. That's fine. I don't like it. I don't like this thingy sticking out here. So what I do, I just put them back. Just like that. That's the only difference I really do. And it looks more sleek that way. But then again, it is your toy. Display it how you wish. The sticker detail, it's actually not bad. Now it's, you know, talk about stickers and the paint. It's not half bad. The silver's gorgeous. I just love the overall look of this thing. It is very clunky, very G1, very grill. You know, could have used a little paint on the wheels, but hey. Did get some glossy black all over this white piece for the tank treads. Got some of the green up here on the wings. Even though they painted this pretty much silver. But that's all for that mode, for car mode. Now we're going to go on to jet mode. Excuse me. Jet mode is quite simple. Not really much to do other than get over here and pull the wings back off again. Disconnect the arms from there. Shrink them. Extend them a little bit. Rotate them. Put them back down. Oops, hold on. Correction. Rotate them. And drop them. Now with the wings straight up so I can actually hold on to this thing. You can just do it that way as well. It's all up to you. You don't have to extend it off the body. Shrink the... that. Keeping that up there. Keeping that there. They say to rotate. Did they say they do that that way? Yes. Sorry, I had to reference a picture. Sorry, I've been fiddling those with this. But there's my mode and their mode, so I get confused between the two. You're going to leave this section just as is. Except, I'm still going to show you how to separate this. Don't worry. You're going to pull this down on the double... there's two joints here. Bring it in. Now, what I did is I shaved a little bit of plastic off of this tab here. Off both this top and the sides there. Plus the tab that is here. I shaved a little off of each side and the top. Now, once we rotate this around, you'll see what I'm talking about. And the tab that's right here, I did the same thing. I shaved a little bit off the top and the sides. Now, this used to gap significantly. I mean, the gap was that, and it wouldn't close. Just like that. But now that I fixed it, I got it a little bit closer, but I can't seem to get it to just clip in and stay. But I think there's plastic. Like, actual, this section here, something's pushing against it that's resisting that push. It's like there's just too much plastic, like right in here. I think that might be it. I think, focus, hello. Light, camera, focus, something. Yeah, I think this one right here, there's too much plastic on that one. I may have to go and shave that one down. That one right there. Because see, these ones are flatter. That one is not. Cool. Anyways, collapse this in. If it does work, I'll report to you. Because it seems to be, you know, meow, 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 meow. But anyways, that's enough said. Take that. There's going to be a little thing right here. That little right there. Push up against it. A little hard. That'll come up. Grab a hold of that. Clip that. Landing gear. Now, we're going to come back down here. Tab slot. Need I say more? Angle the wings how you would like it. And boom. Oh, wait. Not boom. That is jet mode. This way you can take your guns. This tab, again, I do it this way so the guns sit lower. This tab, again, with the wing, and just tab it right in there. Take this gun. Tab it right in there. Just like so. Just like that. Now, that's official. That's the official mode. Take your Titan Master, sitting position. There's a little kind of molded seat in there, but it's not the world's greatest. You just drop him in there. I mean, he rattles. But this is the official mode, first transformation for jet mode. And it is quite beefy and big, in lack of better terms, big and beefy. I mean, you take a trigger happy and just, you know, there you go. There's your size comparison. He's just big. I like it. Very, 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 very nice. Ooh. Make sure you have the two tabs that the guns plug into, you know, over, you know, under the purple piece there. But this is what they originally have. I tweak it up a little bit. I take the headpiece, leave it out like that for the helmet. I extend the arms, okay, completely on both sides. I take this, I gap it up a little bit so it's kind of like that, and I do the same thing on the other side. I zigzag it so the wheel itself is actually touching against there. The fins are still on the outside. Then I take it where I bend it at the elbow, tuck the arm underneath so you have half the helmet there. If you hear some strange noises, that's my rabbit drinking. And tuck it underneath so you have kind of that going on, but you level it out. So now the helmet looks like it's actually part of a tailpiece. And with the hands, I'm bumping the camera with the toy. That's great. Now it looks like one continuous giant thruster in the back. And a wide piece right here, like old school Star Wars thruster. And the helmet's kind of more integrated. Yeah, it's a little gappy here, but hey, Windblade was. And so isn't, you know, Stingray and... Not Stingray, Sideswipe from Transformers. But... It just, I don't know how to describe it other than it's more of a beefier section to hold on to. You know, it just feels better. You know, that's just my opinion, but then again, it is your toy. You can go back to the way it was, or have it this way. It is entirely up to you. I mean, you can even flip the guns where they're, you know, plugged in differently, like so. On the other side, where they're on top instead of underneath. I like them underneath, because of the way that it lands and sits on the landing gear. It just looks better. And it feels more balanced in the back. To me. That's just me. And on to the last mode. Modes. Which, it's pretty much interject, it's the same. Now, you're just going to basically keep everything pretty much the way you had it in jet mode. Where you have, you know, the wheels straight out. I believe. Nope. If the wheel's like this, and like a this, and that, and you take the Titan Master and drop them out, and put away the wings. Then you bring up the head here for the wolf. Now here's where it's interesting. There's a tab right here. There's a slot right there. You just gotta get it lined up just at the right angle, and I'm sorry if I'm off camera with that. But it's a really hard to see. But once you have that angle just right, both sides will actually meet perfectly and catch just right. and it's not catching. Why is it not catching? Because the wing's off. And you'll be able to see the peg, I think. Come on. There we go. Sandwich right in like that. And then what you're supposed to do, put the landing gear down. Separate. Now, here's what I was talking about before I do that. To separate these, you have to... I use the leverage of this bending outward, and it pops that out just fine. Rotate this around, clip that there, bring that out, bring this down and around. And then they tell you to split this, bring the legs back, which they're going to use a sliding mechanism back up there. I think I can do it better on this side, though. There's a track right in there, right there, that this whole bar is going to go right into. It's just going to slide right in and clip. Sometimes it clicks, sometimes it don't click really loud. And then you just put the legs back together, like a show. I said like a show. Oh, Lord. See, again, floppiness. I mean, his hips are just whoop, 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 whoop. It's like Elvis. Stop it. Okay. Closing the legs. Bring the wheel piece back the way it was supposed to be there. And we pretty much have that going on. Okay. Take the guns. Put them back together again. Take this. Now... The two slots where the guns were originally on in tank mode, this tab, it's going to go to this port and this port, just like that if the car stayed together, or the front end stayed together. Although this is mistransformed. Someone's probably yelling at me already. Bring that over, clip that in, bring that in, bring that in, and you can take your Titan Master and plug them in on any of the Titan Master ports, whether it's back here, sitting them in the seat, manning the gun, you know, having them just, you know, manning the sub. The sub. The sub. Actually, I think technically they wanted you to collapse that. But... sub. Here's your size comparison to the sub. Jets don't drift. It is a believable design sub. I mean, it's absolutely cool. If they didn't call it the sub. Space cruiser? Interdimensional flight? Or galactic flight. There we go. It's more like, you know, what you would see in Star Wars and stuff coming down, you know, like, no, but, we G1 fans know what this is. I take Titan Master, fold up his arms. Titan Master peg right there. Plug his little feetsums in. Then I turn it over. G1. The gun. Now, here's my tweaks. Take the gun off. Split the legs. Collapse the legs back down on the double joint again, just like going into car mode. Bring it up and over, bring it down and around. Collapse the legs. Make sure they all click into place. Plug and port. Clip and snip. And then make sure you're over these pegs, leaving the Titan Master still in the same position. Or you can leave them in the head. You can leave them in wolf. You can leave them in the wolf head. Or the head that's inside the chest panel there. You can just leave them in there. Don't matter to me. Your toy. Do as you wish. I extend both arms, rotate, and I extend these back a little bit, just like I did in jet mode. There we go. Doing all that off camera, because I'm zoomed way the hell in. Okay, so extend, I bring this up again, pinching the wheel onto this joint here, slightly zagging that, just like that. And then I take the arms, turn them, so the red parts are down, and bringing in the arms together. So you have that going on again. Because that gives it a full more back, and it's not so in the back end. Stubbing up the whole gun. I angle these out to use these ports. You can angle these as you wish. I try to angle them with the angles of this back here. Splits them a little bit back here, which is fine. Makes it a little bit more stubbier. I bring out this piece right here. So you have little laser ends here, plus laser ends here. You have your four offset guns. I take these guns, and what I do with these is I plug them on the opposite side where that handle's sticking outward, and using that screw hole right there, this way, well, I'll show you. This is what I would consider a better looking sub, for starters. Although I'd flip the guns, probably reconnect them in the front piece. But that would be the better sub, in my book. But this also makes a better G1 blaster, in my opinion. And not to mention, with the gaping hole in the center there, with the guns, it looks like you have a mega blaster plus the little blasters, which is kind of cool. Which is really neat. And again, I've pretty much showed you, and you can use the Titan Master as a trigger. Anyways. So what I do is bring him back into robot mode from here. Just like you would, strand up the legs, like I've shown you before, using the clips, bring back the heels, bring up the toes, turn the legs around, my rabbit's running around in her cage like crazy, collapse the arms in, bring the arms up and around, why am I so zoomed? I am at a bad angle. With this. And then they say, keep that, separate this, bring that down, bring it down and around, over and around, up. Turn the head, or the empty helmet, bring up the hands, turn the wrist, bring up the hand. Here we go, we're almost there. Bring up the wings, straight up. Alright, back into the normal mode, or robot mode. Bring down the head, fold the head, take the head, place them, close them. Now, he is absolutely freaking phenomenal. For a figure of his stature, where they took the original G1 and just gave it a little bit more spice of today's engineering and ability to move around and articulation. The stickers on mine seem to be relatively fine. I have one crooked sticker, and it's on this one, right here. This one was crookedly applied, it's a little over the crease, but you know what? Wah. Some have, you know, differences, others have bad amounts. It's your mileage, it may vary. Sorry. That's just manufacturing. Hasbro, do us a favor And I think everyone can agree, stop applying the stickers for us. I have a little paint smudge right there. I just noticed that. But anyways, stop applying the stickers for us. Seriously. In the instructions, include directions and where to put stickers. Simple as that. We like putting our own stickers on. It's kind of like why we go to third-party companies for details. If you're not going to give us the proper paint applications for the character, then just give us a sticker sheet so we feel like we've done something with it. Something that would look good, even if you're putting out micro stickers. There are some people out there, myself included, that can handle putting on a few stickers even to a Titan Master size character. I mean, hell, I've done that to some of the weaponizer ones from Prime. Anyways, that said, a couple of things I would tweak in robot mode itself. Depending on, again, I told you about the inserting of the wings in there, but the only thing I would do differently in robot mode, and also, I have found a nifty way to store his weapons, which I put them together. I take the port in the back of the wings, plug the gun into there, find the other port on the other side, plug it in. Make sure it's upside down. So this way, those handles are down there. I knew that. Put it straight up. Right into the wings. And there you go. Storage for the weapons. And I also went as far as I dug these out from my strafe from Dark of the Moon. No. Wow. Dark of the Moon. Seriously? No. Age of Extinction. And I give him the little swords, so he has some sort of swords. I would like to have him have bigger swords, but he can also not fit him that way. Well, maybe not. Thought he could. No, his hands are too deep, and he... Yeah, no. So, yeah, pretty much give him a couple little swords. I mean, he is a ninja, for crying out loud. But kind of a cool thing. I mean, you give me a little bit more time and I could do that, but I've already bored you guys for about 56 minutes. So, you know, my final thoughts, absolutely. Does he belong in your collection? If you're a true G1 fan of Six Shot or even Quick Switch, which they're going to be utilizing this mold as a different repaint for Quick Switch. However, Quick Switch was such a different transformation, such a different bot in general. Oh, and size comparison to him in robot mode? Oops. Here's a few size comparisons here. Or... just in case those who have older transformations. I'm messing up words big time. It's been a long day. Older Transformers. Another triple changer that is absolutely awesome that I just reviewed recently, and you would absolutely adore him. He is awesome and fantastic. If you don't got him in any other which way, shape, or form of mold, try to get him. Springer is fantastic, too. Now... with that said, Six Shot is definitely a figure I do recommend you getting if you can. If you can find him definitely cheaper than what they're asking for on market today, please, by all means, take it up. Because you spend the $46 to $50 now, it is well worth it. You turn around and spend $20, $40-ish, $30, $35, is still a great deal. It is definitely worth the hunk of money to put down on this guy because he is awesome. He is the G1 with better articulation, with the same transformation designs, and a new headmaster gimmick that I absolutely love. And that's about it for all of that. Oh, hold on a second. I did put it on Twitter earlier, a picture of him in base mode. I'll put a link in the description to my Twitter down below. Like, comment, subscribe, check out my Twitter, check out some of my art stuff. I will have probably some pictures and stuff of stills of my custom of the other two guys that I just showed off. Videos are in the description below for those. Not much detail there other than what I did with them, but that's that. Anything else to mention other than if you want to see the base mode, other than just the picture, please leave me a comment. I may do a transformation video on that. All right. Cool. All right. This has been Thrumnal. Thank you for watching. Sorry to bore you for so long, but he's not easy to work with some of his looseness. But all in all, great figure. This has been Thrumnal. It has been real. It has been fun. And remember, you're only as old as you feel.